Welcome to World Action and Reaction News. Today we will try to find can robotics help India's defense sector? If yes then, how much? Imagine a robotic sepoy, Robbie, monitoring the movement of the enemy from across the international border. Robbie is 6 feet tall, can travel 6 kilometers an hour, weighs 450 kilograms, and can spin on a dime. It has been programmed to select and engage targets without intervention by a human operator. Robbie can track multiple moving targets using infrared and visible light cameras and see up to a distance of 2,000 meters at night. It can give a warning to an intruder, and if not obeyed, fire a lethal shot with a deadly accuracy when the intruder is within a range of 250 to 300 meters. It can also jam radios and cell phones nearby. Robbie is not alone. It is one of the many armed robots positioned at the international border to serve as the first line of defense. Robbie is a robotic weapon system. It is unaffected by the emotions and stress that cause soldiers to overreact or deliberately disobey rules of engagement and commit war crimes. Robbie will be on duty 24 hours, for 365 days under all weather conditions. It will not ask for leave, won't go to sleep and won't require food. It will only require regular charging and if nuclear powered, it would remain active for years without any recharge. It will also not require any expenditure on healthcare, accommodation, or entertainment, nor will it ask for pension on retirement. What is more, it will not pose disciplinary problems such as desertion, disobedience, and fratricide. In a number of countries, militaries are planning for a day when sentry robotic warriors like Robbie will stand guard at borders, ready to identify the enemy and kill them, without an order from a human soldier. A few countries have already produced and deployed robotic military systems. When the United States forces went into Iraq in 1991, there were no robotic systems on the ground. By the end of 2004, there were 150 robots on the ground in Iraq, a year later there were 2,400, and by the end of 2008, there were about 12,000 robots of nearly 24 varieties. Robotic weapon systems have also been deployed at the Israeli-Palestinian border and the Korean Demilitarized Zone. Robots are also being designed to carry the load for soldiers traveling on foot in extreme terrain and to rescue the wounded. It is very likely that robotic warriors developed in the next 2 decades will have the capability to hunt, identify, authenticate, and possibly kill a target without a human in the decision loop. It is claimed by the proponents of robotic weapon systems that they would be capable of adhering to the rules of international humanitarian law and would, in fact, perform more ethically than soldiers in the battlefield. Robotic warriors would process battlefield information faster and more efficiently. They could also be deployed at a much greater speed than human soldiers, and would act as force multipliers, thus expanding the capacity and reach of the armed forces. These warriors would also be able to survive in an inhospitable environment and could be deployed for hazardous tasks that are too risky for combatants for a longer period of time. Most importantly, their destruction would not result in the loss of irreplaceable human life. If and when they are used in a combat, they would be able to use lethal force more conservatively than combatants. Further, they would be more accurate and effective than a combatant, thus reducing collateral damage and other mistakes made by a combatant. Today, at least 44 countries, including China, France, Germany, India, Israel, South Korea, Russia, the UK, and the US have robotic weapon system capabilities. The DRDO has developed a fully automated remote-controlled robot, capable to recover bombs. Maybe in the near future, robotic warriors would be deployed in sensitive border conflict zones, including the so-called line of control dividing India and China/Pakistan.
Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, WARN.